Dave McMahon is the referee for tonight's game. Tom Donaldson and Brad Jones are our linesmen.
Now this game was very fast, exciting, extremely close, only two penalties, a hooking infraction that led to a penalty shot, some goals waved off, another controversial goal allowed, iron hit at both ends, and Osoyoos playing a penalty-free hockey game. Here are the highlights.
Coming in is Tyson Klingspoll. There's a shot right in front, they score! Maybe not. The goal might not be counting, but it looked like it was in the net, but the referee's whistle had gone. And a little quick whistle on that one too, because it really wasn't a frozen puck. It was tapped into the net, but McMahon had the whistle gone, and the play was ruled dead. Long flip pass up for Holawaty. He's trying to get in the clear, and he was knocked down and goes right down into the... Going to be a penalty on the play. So as Blake Holawaty was hauled down, and he's going to get the chance to get the game's first goal on the penalty shot. Here it comes. Works right in. And went to the backhand, and a good move by Huber. And he made the save on it. Gets it to Holes. There's a pass up, and Neary had it go off and down into the corner. He tries to swipe it in front, he scores! Oh, maybe not. I don't think it's going to be counted here. Let's find out. Dahl's knocked in by a high stick. Knocked in by a high stick, he says. Got an alley on the left side, but he's all alone right now. Everybody's gone for a change. He goes down to the corner. Now Jewel is back out and digs the puck loose in behind the net. Hill has it back along the boards now to Stone score! That one's going to count. Coming in with McLeese, Neary in behind the net. Still has it, dodges away from a check, gets the puck, and comes up and lets a shot go high, going for the glove corner and just wide. Coyotes move the puck around, a shot is wide too. Sandhold, another one tap. They bang at it, they score! Riley Pettis complaining it was a high stick, and he might have an argument there. Being checked though was Klingspoll. Coming right in, pass over the far side to Mattis, to McLeese, shot! Loose in front, kicked at it! No goal! Well, that's going to be kicked in, and Dave McMahon is already yelling it. And you can see that puck was kicked in. And it looked like McLeese, as he is going by, put the boots to it. There's a pad save and the rebound kicked out. And oh, look out, that was handed right out in front. Another shot and a save again as they're all around the net and the buzzer goes. Just as there is a real pileup. But then the steam get it, and here they come, trying to come right in with a shot, run, and they score! Garrett Malchow coming down and got the puck over to Wyatt Gale. And Gale just was able to slide it into the corner of the net. 2-1, Coyotes in the lead, Summerland coming on. Senholt. He was on the injury list coming into the play. There's a shot. They tie it up. Mills. They don't. There's another one. That one went off the iron. You could hear it up here. Actually coming up down is going to be against the steam. So this is the first time we're actually going to have a power play in the game. 30 seconds remaining in the regulation time. Penalty will carry over in overtime. Now here comes Glimpa. Comes down over the line, works to the corner. Tries to center it. Scores! McLeese! The buzzer and a disappointing loss for the Summerland team, and a big win for the Coyotes, all coming with 11 seconds left to go.
The third star from the Osoyoos Coyotes, number 25, Daniel Stone. The second star from the Summerland team, number 14, Jared Malcho. And the first star from the Osoyoos Coyotes, number 13, Troy McLeese.
So McLeese gets the winning goal with 11 seconds left to go.
It was a tough weekend for Summerland. The following night, they were leading Osoyoos 3-1 in the third period before Reiner Glimpel scored a pair of goals to tie the game. Jackson Tomatis then nailed the winner with just over a minute left in the second overtime period. The Steam claiming goaltender interference on it, but to no avail. The 4 points for Osoyoos just about guarantees them a first place finish in the Okanagan Division, and they continue to lead the KIJHL with 61 points.